You people that are against fighting, you should be ashamed of yourself. You took advantage of that to make your point on fighting. You should be ashamed of yourself for doing something like that. But the ones that I am really disgusted with, and I hate to say this when the kids are listening, what George LaRocque said about the bunch of pukes that fought before, Stu Grimson, Chris Nyland, and Jim, what's Thompson, the reason that they're drinking drugs and alcoholics because they fight. You turncoats, you hypocrites.
That's awesome. Don Cherry just giving her, letting her rip. Hey, joining me to talk about the controversy that the CBC is turning on Don Cherry is a man who knows a little bit about political correctness in the sports broadcasting suite. My friend Damian Goddard, who was here on the show before, thanks for being back.
Good to see you, man.
Before we jump into Don Cherry's kerfuffle, right, Let's get a quick update on your case. Last time we talked to you, you were... if I'm saying it right, you were sacked by Sports, Sportsnet Rogers because of a comment you made, not on the air, but in a Twitter tweet about same-sex marriage.
Twitter account made a statement.
Give us an update on things there.
Well, the paperwork is now in front of the Human Rights Commission.
Right.
That's really all I can say right now. This is new territory for me. We'll see how it works out. But again, I'm as confident today as I was back then.
Well, keep us posted on that. Listen, you're the perfect guy to talk about this. What we just saw Don Cherry there, to me, that's vintage Cherry. He's letting her rip. I mean, he's causing a debate. Personally, I side with him. I mean, if you don't want pushing and shoving in hockey, then have it tag hockey or, you know, ballet or figure skating. What do you think of what he said?
Well, first of all, I was happy that he went 3-for-3 in the name pronunciations there with the former NHL enforcers. That, to me, was a victory in itself. And further, I do agree with you. It's a fine line I ride here, because while I am not an advocate per se of fighting in hockey, I just don't like the glorification of hockey. If it's going to happen, it's going to happen. And I have a tough time wrapping my head around people who want to treat these players as little children.
You know, and he was pointing out that some of the critics today are folks who were enthusiasts of fighting before. I mean, listen, like you, people don't go to watch a boxing match, but if the elbows get up and there's some heavy checking, a little bit of scrapping, welcome to the sport.
It's ingrained in the sport. It happens. You get penalized for fighting in hockey, so it's not necessarily...
So it's limited. It's restricted.
It's limited. I don't want to sound like a champion for what Don Cherry is saying, is that fighting is good for the game. I don't believe it is. But I have a real problem with the people that are coming out and with this character assassination of Don Cherry.
Well, and that's why we're talking about our show here, as you know. We don't talk a lot about sports. We're more about the politics. And the CBC made this political. Can I read to you from a press release put out by the senior vice president of the CBC, basically, I think, throwing Don Cherry under the bus? They haven't sacked him like you were, but maybe that's because his contract has some... So let me read this. This is the CBC. Don's comments reflect his own personal opinion. While we support his right to voice that opinion, we do not share his position. Player safety is a top priority for the CBC, and we support the initiatives of the NHL and others in keeping players safe on and off the ice. And then she goes on. This is Christine Stewart. She says, "Yesterday, I spoke personally with NHL Commissioner Gary Bettman and reiterated our shared commitment to player safety at all levels in the game." So not only are they saying we disagree with Cherry, but imagine some CBC nerd picking up the phone and calling the head of the NHL and saying, we don't like this and we want everyone to be safe. Is your job to report the news and comment on it, or to change public policy?
Your job is to allow the people you hire to do their job. They hired Don Cherry to go up on set every Saturday night during hockey season and to expose his ideas and opinions.
He's the most popular guy on the network.
Absolutely.
You know, love him or hate him, you got to watch him. Yeah. He's got such a personality.
Sure.
And for some nerd...
Can I say one thing as well, too, Ezra? He is a proud Canadian, and I just want people to remember that this is the same guy who climbs up on that set and sheds a tear when he's reading the names of people that have fallen for our country in wartime.
And he supports the troops in Afghanistan.
Absolutely.
His blood is maple syrup. I mean, that guy is as Canadian as it gets. And I think he is. I mean, I am a very big critic of the state broadcaster, but if anyone does reflect Canada, I think it's him. What do you make about his boss not, you know, almost tattling to the teacher, calling up Gary Bettman and saying, "I disagree with John Cherry"? Who the hell asked you, Christine Stewart?
Well, I just think that in itself is a little suspect as well, too. And it just shows the kowtowing while you're trying to ride that fine line of also not smashing your cash cow in the mouth.
Well, that's the thing.
Because tons of people want to hear what Don Cherry has to say. And I happen to believe this as well, too. The guy is not the most educated of people, didn't go to post-secondary school. I have this inkling that in this crazy, mad world that we live in right now, I happen to believe that he just voices his opinion in a way that just well, it's not politically correct. Yeah. And I have this feeling that he wants women to tell their little boys to grow up to be men.
Yeah. Oh, exactly. You know what? He speaks with a... I think the way he talks is how normal people talk when they're watching TV,
absolutely,
at the bar,
sure,
at the coffee shop, when they're not worried that some Christine Stewart is watching over them and say, oh, you made a politically incorrect comment. I think that normal people talk like him. They may, yeah, not all agree with him, but he is far more normal than anyone. You know what? I don't know how many people are watching documentaries on cheese making,
no,
in,
right,
northern,
right,
Saskatchewan,
oh, so
on,
true,
the CBC. He gets more viewers than the rest of them combined. But what's weird to me, I'm going to read that one last,
yeah,
sentence.
Sure.
This is, again, Christine Stewart, the CBC's executive vice president, saying, I spoke to Gary Bettman about our shared commitment to player safety at all levels of the game. Is the CBC some nanny organization promoting, you know, safety, or are they reporting the game and commenting on the game? Like, are you a broadcaster, or are you some social worker?
I think you nailed it right there. That, to me, is astounding, considering that Don Cherry speaks for himself.
Last question. Why is Don Cherry putting up with it? Is it the dough? Is it because he loves to talk to a million folks every week?
He is a passionate Canadian, and again, I've never really sat down with the man in a one-on-one circumstance, but he's passionate, he believes in what he says, and he's a passionate Canadian who believes that men should be treated like men.
How much crap do you think he'll take from the CBC brass before he walks?
I don't think he cares.
Yeah, you know,
he doesn't care.
You're probably right.
He does not care.
Yeah, who's heard of Christine Stewart? No one's even heard,
yeah,
of her. Everyone knows Don Cherry.
Absolutely.
Damien Goddard, thanks so much for being
I wonder
here.
If there's going to be an Occupy CBC. No,
yeah.
I don't think that'll happen for a guy as conservative as Don.
You're probably
that
right.
Might not happen.
Hey, great to see you again. Thanks for,
yeah,
being on the show, Damien Goddard.
Care.